One of the issues that has plagued Africa is that of kleptocrats who enrich themselves at the expense of their country's development. From Mobutu Sese Seko in Zaire to Omar Bongo in Gabon, this has proved to be an issue time and time again, and today's subject of this video, General Sani Abacha of Nigeria, is no different. According to the estimates cited by the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, Nigeria lost $400 billion to corruption between 1960 and 1999. Some of that can be traced back to the rule of the dictator General Sani Abacha, whom the Nigerian government accused of looting more than $2.2 billion from state coffers when he ruled the country from 1993 until his death, apparently from a heart attack in June of 1998. Even corruption watchdog Transparency International estimates that he stole as much as $5 billion of public money during that time. In this video, we take a look at the life of General Sani Abacha and how he managed to swindle such large amounts of money from the country of Nigeria. Sani Abacha was born on 20 September 1943 and was educated in Kano, Nigeria. Abacha received his formal military training at Nigerian and British military training colleges. In 1969, he fought during the Nigerian Civil War as a platoon and battalion commander. By the way, you can catch my video on the Nigerian Civil War in the description box down below. The military career of Abacha was marked by involvement in all military coups in Nigeria. When he was still a second lieutenant with the 3rd Battalion in Kaduna, he took part in the July 1966 Nigerian counter-coup from the conceptual stage. Abacha would rise through the ranks in the Nigerian military and by 1983 had achieved the rank of Brigadier when he assisted Ibrahim Babangida in overthrowing the then president, Shehu Shagari. Shehu Shagari had been elected to his second presidential term in 1983. After this coup, the current president of Nigeria, General Muhammad Buhari, became Nigeria's leader. But just 2 years later, Ibrahim Babangida overthrew Buhari and installed himself as the leader with Sani Abacha as his second in command. Sani Abacha was later appointed the Minister of Defense in 1990. The elections that were subsequently held in 1993 were won by Moshood Abiola, a candidate who was supposedly supported by Ibrahim Babangida. However, General Sani Abacha immediately overthrew this government and took control of Nigeria. Although Abacha promised a return to democracy, his actions were anything but democratic. He banned political activity of any kind, fired a large portion of the military, controlled the press, and assembled a personal security force of some 3,000 men. In September of 1994, he issued a decree that placed his government above the jurisdiction of the courts, effectively giving him absolute power. Another decree gave him the right to detain anyone for up to 3 months without trial.
Consequently, the following decisions come into immediate effect. The interim national government is hereby dissolved. The national and state assemblies are also dissolved. The state executive councils are dissolved. The brigade commanders are to take over from the governors in their states until administrators are appointed. Where there are no brigade commanders, the commissioners of police in the states are to take over. All local governments stand dissolved. The directors of personnel are to take over the administration of the local governments until administrators are appointed. The National Electoral Commission is hereby dissolved. All former secretaries to federal ministries are to hand over to their director generals until ministers are appointed. The two political parties are hereby dissolved. All processions, political meetings, and associations of any type in any part of the country are hereby banned.
Also, former military ruler Olusegun Obasanjo was jailed for treason and accused of plotting a coup together with General Oladipo Dia. In 1997, General Shehu Yar'Adua was also jailed and died in custody. Wole Soyinka, Nigeria's Nobel laureate, was also charged with treason, although he had voluntarily left the country. But perhaps Abacha's most brutal act was the imprisonment, trial, and subsequent execution for treason of writer Ken Saro-Wiwa and other Ogoni activists who were concerned with the environmental exploitation of their region by multinational petroleum companies. Before I go into the details of how Sani Abacha swindled Nigeria, I would like to state that it wasn't all doom and gloom under his administration. Abacha's administration oversaw an increase in the country's foreign exchange reserves from $494 million in 1993 to $9.6 billion in the middle of 1997. They also reduced the external debt of Nigeria from $36 billion in 1993 to $27 billion by 1997. Abacha would also construct between 25 to 100 kilometers of urban roads in major cities such as Kano, Kusau, Aba, Lagos, and Port Harcourt. Anyways, let's delve into the great heist by the Abacha administration. Rumors of how he and his family had enriched themselves by some $3 billion, most of it held in European banks, started coming out after his sudden death in 1998. On the 8th of June 1998, Abacha died in the Aso Rock presidential villa in Abuja, Nigeria. He was buried on the same day, according to Muslim tradition, without an autopsy, fueling speculation that he may have been assassinated. The government of Nigeria identified the cause of his death as a sudden heart attack, but it is believed by foreign diplomats, including United States intelligence analysts, that he may have been poisoned. After his death, a special investigation panel was inaugurated by his military successor, General Abdusalam Abubakar, to trace and recover money that had been looted from the state coffers. Just weeks after the commencement of investigations, details began to filter out. On the 6th of September 1998, General Abubakar announced that investigators had uncovered 130 bank accounts in 50 foreign and local banks where billions stolen from the public treasury, notably the Central Bank of Nigeria, were kept. General Sani Abacha's former national security advisors also told investigators that he had helped the dictator collect a sum of $456 million and £232 million from the Central Bank of Nigeria between June of 1996 and October 1997. The Swiss Justice Ministry confirmed that almost all of nearly $500 million frozen in Swiss bank accounts connected with the late Nigerian dictator was obviously of criminal origin and would be returned to the Nigerian government. The criminal origin of these assets was also confirmed. These were kickbacks paid by multinationals, especially oil companies, contracts for supplies or construction works awarded at inflated costs to firms linked to the dictator. There were also direct withdrawals from the Central Bank of Nigeria for purchases, jobs, and services that were never performed. It is believed that General Sani Abacha and members of his cabinet stole at least $2 billion from the Central Bank of Nigeria alone. Facts about Abacha's criminal network were not hard to find. Perhaps this was due to the fact that Abacha's death was unexpected, leaving little or no time for him to cover his tracks. As more and more of the investigation was being done and much of the loot being discovered, General Abubakar consequently requested the cooperation of the countries where the funds were being kept. He also took steps to recover some assets that were held locally in Nigeria. By the time he had left office in May of 1999, General Abubakar had overseen the retrieval of $825 million from the Abacha family, while $1.3 billion had been frozen in Switzerland, Luxembourg, and Liechtenstein. On a side note, it was General Abdusalam Abubakar that oversaw Nigeria's return to an elected civilian government in 1999. There would be further success by the Nigerian government to retrieve stolen funds. In 2020, the United States Department of Justice released a statement to say that it had transferred approximately $300 million to the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in accordance with a trilateral agreement among the governments of the United States, Nigeria, and the Bulwark of Jersey, which is one of the Channel Islands between Britain and France. This agreement was to repatriate assets that the United States had forfeited that were traceable to the kleptocracy of the former Nigerian dictator, Sani Abacha, and his co-conspirators. These laundered funds were recovered from confiscated assets belonging to the son of the late dictator, Mohamed Abacha. It is said that the funds were laundered through the United States banking system and then held in bank accounts in Jersey in the name of Doraville Properties Corporation, a British Virgin Islands company, and in the name of the son of the ex-military ruler. However, the companies linked to the Abacha family went to court to try and prevent repatriation of the funds, alleging infringements of their rights to a fair trial. According to the Nigerian government, these funds that have been uncovered would be administered by Nigeria's Sovereign Wealth Fund and would be used to develop road infrastructure that will boost supply chain connections and economic growth. General Sani Abacha's story is an epitome of what is wrong with the continent of Africa and one of the reasons that have caused our continent to lag behind. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about Sani Abacha's story and measures that can be put in African countries to stop such things from occurring. If you are new here, don't be shy to subscribe and to click the notifications bell so that you don't miss out on any new uploads. Also, don't forget to like and share the video if you enjoyed it. Thank you all for tuning in. This has been Tatenda for African Biographics. Until next time, cheers. Have a good one.